We present to you the haunts of 355 West 8th Avenue.
Goodbye, kids. Goodbye.
Bye-bye. Your nightmares will come true.
Interesting. I wouldn't have guessed the movie would end like that.
Dude, that movie was effed up. I don't know why I watched that demented stuff.
Relax, it's not like it's for real.
Well, I'm beginning to wonder if there's some stuff like this going on in this apartment building.
Now you're just being silly, babe.
I'm serious. I've been feeling some weird energy around this building. Something ain't right.
Weird energy? You sound like one of those Eugene hippies. What's next? You gonna say your chakra has been disturbed or something?
It's not just an energy thing. I've been hearing odd sounds throughout this building.
This is a 1920s apartment building. It always makes weird sounds. Shoot, every time the wind blows, it creaks.
I've heard creepier sounds than creaks.
Jeez, I've been showing you too many horror films this Halloween season. You are cut off.
You should take this more seriously. I'm heading to bed.
Women.
Last night sucked. I woke up in a heavy sweat from some horrible nightmare. It was worse and more real than I've ever had.
It makes sense that you would have a nightmare considering the horror films we've seen recently.
Also, when I was awake, I heard some creepy sounds in this apartment. There were oohs and screeches and sounds like that.
One of the apartment windows was left open. That must have been it.
These were other sounds.
You ever hear that psychological thing when you hear and see what you're expecting to hear or see sometimes?
Nah, I wasn't imagining this, I swear!
What you need to do is to calm your ass down. Head down the street and enjoy some of the recently legal recreational stuff.
You are starting to piss me off! I have legitimate concerns here!
Take some deep breaths, relax, and go to sleep. I'll be there shortly. I bet you're going to sleep well tonight. Why are you so focused on your laptop right now? We're watching TV.
I heard weird stuff again last night. I've got to find out what the history of this apartment building is. There has to be some information on this messed up place.
Don't worry about it. Pay attention to the show, babe.
Also, I realized today that I haven't even seen any other tenants in this building. Have you?
We've only lived here for a week. We don't know their schedules or the amount of time they're typically out of town.
Whoa! Here it is! So, it says this apartment building used to be one big mansion in the 1930s. Some wealthy lumberyard owner lived here. Apparently, they were like big deer hunters too. Eventually, this mansion was broken up into four sections. That's why there are four apartments now.
Does it say why it was separated?
I'm looking, but I don't see. Whoa! It says that there are many myths associated with this building. There is supposedly a book with some secrets tucked away somewhere in this building. We gotta find that book!
This sounds like a childish game.
I told you something is effed up! Look at this text!
You have what I want. That could mean a lot of things.
A lot of them are good, I bet.
I bet I know what it is. One of your friends is messing with you. Who do you know that likes to play practical jokes?
It says the number is $1945? What the hell is that?
Whoever this friend is, you have to hand it to him or her for the commitment to this.
Nah, this would be overdoing it. We need that book right away.
Okay, I'll play along and help you find this book. Where do you think it'd be?
Well, it wouldn't be stored in any of the apartments themselves. The only other place it could be is in the small, creepy upstairs room. You've got to go up there, but I'm afraid for you.
I reckon I'll be fine.
Let's go fast. What do you see up there?
It's pretty cool. It's definitely creepy.
Do you see the book?
Nah, but I do see some hunting supplies, some clothes.
That must be the deer hunting supplies they used.
I see the book. That's dusty as hell.
Good. What's it say?
Its title is The Haunts of 355 West 8th Avenue. It says, enter at your own risk.
Let's get out of here.
Damn it, the door won't open.
I knew it. This place is possessed. I'm calling 911.
911, what's the emergency?
My boyfriend's been attacked in our apartment building! His hand was bitten off! The attacker is still in the building! I think there's more around here!
Okay, what's your address?
I'm at 355 West 8th Avenue, apartment B in Eugene!
Okay, 355 West 8th Avenue. That rings a bell. 355 West 8th Avenue. 355 West 8th Avenue.
No time to waste, sir! Send people immediately!
Alright! 355 West 8th Avenue. Ah, hell no, I ain't sending nobody to that haunted-ass house!
You know about this house being haunted?
Sure do! A few weeks ago, some firefighters went in there and came out seriously disturbed! They had to be discharged because they were never right after that.
You're not even going to try to help us?
Nope. When people are battling fires or robbers, we get there in a flash. But if you're dealing with demons, you're on your own. Good luck, lady.
What the hell? Since when does 911 say you're on your own?
I'm sorry I doubted you. We gotta get to the bottom of this. Let's see what's in that book.
It says, herein lies the disturbing past of 355 West 8th Avenue and the concerns for its future. It all started in the 1940s when the building was one large house resided by the Lincoln family, which is why the nearest cross street is named Lincoln. The Lincolns acquired wealth by owning and operating a lumber mill. In 1943, the oldest son was cutting a tree, tripped, and ended up having a rotating blade cut right through his head. He survived. but it created permanent brain damage. After that, he exhibited strange behaviors and occasional psychotic episodes. They had to isolate him, so they blocked off a section of the house upstairs for him. Shortly after, the youngest son was punished for bad behavior. He was sentenced to work in the undesirable chemical room at the mill. After inhaling too many fumes, he started exhibiting destructive behaviors while sleepwalking. Of the night, he would roam the house, eat glass, rip curtains, pull out his own hair, and do other weird things like that. The family decided to isolate him as well, so they blocked off another section of the house upstairs for him.
So there were two chambers upstairs and one downstairs. I'm seeing the pattern.
It says the cat story. Cat story? This family often participated in deer hunting. There was one deer they hunted that was completely bizarre. Before it was shot, they witnessed it crushing beehives, kicking rabbits, and it ate a fox. After it was shot several times, it did a backflip and then ran full speed into barbed wire, during which it was decapitated. Even while decapitated, it crushed a squirrel and then humped a bear!
That is so effing weird.
Seriously? Well, it says here, the cray-cray deer.
It doesn't actually say cray-cray, right?
Surprisingly, it does. I didn't know that phrase was that old. Anyway, the deer was brought into the house and its blood was stored in a jar for scientific analysis. Meanwhile, there was a cat living in the house. One night, the cat came upon the jar of the deer blood. The cat drank some of it, and the cat was never the same. It would fly in the air and do flips. It would latch onto people, bite them, pull out people's hair, break objects, etc. They needed to isolate this cat as well, so they broke up the house into one more section.
So now we know why there are four sections to the house.
Eventually, the cat's behavior was too much for the family, so they executed it. The mother loved the cat and became very emotionally disturbed by all this.
You killed my cat.
She became so angry, she searched for the deer blood and drank it herself. All hell broke loose at that point. She got the other crazed siblings to drink the blood. The mother became so crazed, the family executed her as well. Shortly before she died, she screamed, 70 years I return to pass it on. This year was 1945.
70 years later.
2015 is 70 years later. Damn.
Indeed, the bitch is back. That must have been what the dollar sign 1945 was about. You have what I want. You have what... I know what she wants.
Baby. A baby.
Give me what I want. Your baby.
What the hell are we gonna do? This door won't open. 9/11 ain't helping. There's gotta be someone else to call.
Well,
if there's something strange in my neighborhood. Who I'm gonna call? Ghostbusters!
What, Ghostbusters are real too?
It's worth a Google search. There it is!
I'll be damned. Give them a call.
Ghostbusters, how can I help you?
I seriously need your help. We have a crazy ghost situation in our apartment building.
What's the addy?
355 West 8th Avenue.
Got it.
The front door isn't opening. You will need to go through the back door.
I'll be there in 30 seconds.
Wow, they're actually coming?
Really quickly.
Let's go inside to see this go down.
The Ghostbuster is here! He's going to save us!
Alright, Ghost, you met your match. A Ghostbuster is in the motherfucking house!
Something strange in the neighborhood. Who you gonna call?
Ghostbusters!
If there's something weird and it don't look good, who you gonna call?
Ghostbusters!
I ain't afraid of no ghosts.
Prepare to die, you ghostly bastards.
Son of a bitch! They killed the Ghostbuster!
Even the Ghostbuster couldn't do anything. I guess it makes sense since they aren't really ghosts, but some sort of ghost-zombie hybrids.
We're so screwed! Wait! Why haven't we called the landlord?
Oh yeah, duh, call him!
What up, Julie?
Horrible stuff! This apartment is haunted and they're after us! I need you to get here ASAP!
Damn it. They're back. I'll be there in a second.
Whoa, the door didn't open for us.
You know, it sticks sometimes and you have to turn the handle a couple of times.
Do you think this entire time we thought we were stuck in this building?
It's time to take care of these ghosts. Let's head in. Good thing I have this special anti-ghost zombie magic candle. Light this thing. You ghosts ain't got nothing on this candle. Peace out. Deficit omne quad narcissica.
I'm pretty sure that Latin pronunciation sucked. But it worked!
Put some butter on them, they're toast.
Oh, thank God you came!
Don't be too happy. These guys are gone, but there are others.
More? Man, we're out of this apartment.
No, you're not. Bad news for y'all.
What?
Y'all have seen too much. If word gets out, no one will rent from me. You both have to die.
You son of a bitch.
What is going on here? Play in the apartment? This is nuts. No, absolutely not.
Damn it. I guess this is it. There are only two of us, and there is a full one of him.
This play is over, people. I'm the landlord. Not acceptable. You bastards think you own this place or what? Christ's sake. Everybody out.
Interesting, right?